Hi guys, I'm Kirk from Dick's Taxidermy, and today we're going to show you how we turn the ears, the lips, and the nose on a mule deer. So we're going to turn these ears so that we can get salt on the skin side, on the inside, so we set this hair on both sides. So a turned ear looks like this, it's inside out. We can salt both sides, and then that will preserve the skin so the hair doesn't come out. Also on the nose too, we have this septum in here, and that's a lot of fleshy tissue, and all of this hair would slip off the nose if we didn't split this septum and turn this nose to get that salt all the way down to the hair. So we're going to show you how we do that, and this is actually what it looks like once we get the septum split and everything salted. Then it preserves all the hair so we don't get any slippage. Same way with the lips. You can see here the lips are turned so that we can get the salt in there too. Once you get that done, then your cape is preserved and it will have shelf life so it doesn't slip. So we'll get started on that. Well, we just finished turning the lips, the nose, and the ears on this mule deer cape. So I wanted to kind of go over quickly the tools that we use. You always see me use these cotton gloves. I'm not using these gloves to keep my hands clean. I'm using these gloves to be able to grip the skin, and it keeps me from slipping. I can get a good grip on it, I can pull, I can stretch, and it's easy for me to grab onto the skin and hold on. If I use my bare hands, my hands get slick from the fat and the oils, and it's just hard to hold. So that's what I use the cotton gloves for. The next thing that I use, of course, is this Buck 102. This is a buck knife, Buck 102. I'll hold it up where you can see it. Has about a 4-inch blade on it. You'll see that we use this for everything, for caping, for boning our meat. And we definitely using it here on turning lips, nose, and ears and doing all of our caping in the shop. So that's one important tool that I use, the Buck 102. It's a very good knife, it's a good hard blade. And I will be doing a video in the future here on this knife and then the stones that I use that allow me to get this knife very sharp. Also, you'll see me here with a couple steels. This one is a standard steel that you normally see. This is a ceramic steel. This is ceramic material here. This will take off a little bit more material. This steel here is a smoother steel, a little bit finer cutting edge. Doesn't take off quite as much material, but it will sharpen your knives up very quickly. So again, these are two important items that I use. And then you did see me use this tool here. This is basically an ear turner, opener, whatever you want to call it. You see me use that where I pushed in there and opened the ear up and forced it open. And again, this is something you wouldn't have in a field, you'd have in a shop. You don't need to have this in the field. This is for production work. It's to make our job a little quicker, faster, easier. But in the field, I only use my steel to turn the ears. So in other words, I will go in here and I will move my steel sideways like that and break those fibers loose as I move up the ear. Takes a little bit of practice. But you can learn to use a steel like this, and it will provide you enough leverage to get in there and break those fibers loose, and you'll be able to turn that ear inside out. So this is a good tool. Of course, you're going to need this in the field when you're sharpening your knives. So you can use this to turn your ears and keep your knives sharp.